Good morning for the people in Europe, and good afternoon for the people in China. First of all, I would like to thank the University of the Beagle for providing me the chance for present the topic video conference. Okay, and now I think I will start my topic today, the presentation. So the presentation title is the Integrated Coastal Management Application in Environmental Restoration, a case study in Xiamen, China. I will take Xiamen as a case to introduce how to use the Integrated Coastal Management as the coastal management tools an approach for to implement some activities for the environmental restoration. Can you hear me clear?
Yes, we can hear you perfectly.
Okay, yeah, so I will continue. Okay, I think I need to introduce some about the definition of the integrated coastal management first. ICM is defined as a coastal management system designed to regulate human activities for preserving ecosystem functions and service so as to achieve environmental and economic sustainability and other social goals of the sustainable development. And for easy to understand, I think I needed to have a ICM interpretation as the three words ICM integrated, that means the policy and the functional integration. Here, okay, the integration means. And the coastal here, we emphasize on the land-sea interface. And the management here is our regulating human activities towards achieving economic and environmental sustainability and equity. So the ICM system is made up of the variables like the frameworks, the policy and the management frameworks, the mechanism, like the coordinating, implementing, consensus building, and like the process, for example, planning, partnership, building, and monitoring, and so on. And working in the integrated and coordinating phases to deliver outputs and outcomes of an ICM program. So, ICM actually could be concluded for some characteristic features. One is ICM adopts an integrated, holistic decision-making framework to address competing and conflicting use of the coastal areas, including those seriously affecting sustainable development, like poverty, equated environment and governance. And it used interactive, process-oriented approach to integrate cross-cutting issues, linking science and policy, and emphasize local level actions. And the third, each incremental programmatic, strategic, people focus, involve stakeholders, and create the ownership. And the fourth, it improves coastal governance through strategic planning, policy and management integration, and in the agency coordination. And the fifth, it plays focus to quantify or it do best for quantify ecosystem service so as to enable policy considerations of trade-off. And last, he pushed the basic coastal policy and management fundamentals in place so as to cope with economic and environmental challenges. I think this is the could conclude from the ICM framework some characteristic features. And the following, I will try to introduce how to use this and how to implement the ICM in the environmental restoration. And I think this kind of characteristics features that will be integrated in the, some kind of the, implementation of the environmental restoration in Xiamen. So, following, I would like to introduce some Xiamen ICM. Firstly, I need to let you to understand some about Xiamen. So, Xiamen is located in the southeastern of China. And they have some activities for the coastal and marine activities like the port and city, the fisheries, the mineral production, tourism, and coastal reclamation and construction. And such kind of the ocean industry, the barrier add to the Xiamen GDP, contributes to Xiamen GDP is about 20%. And Xiamen is a special economic zone, is one of the special economic zones in China. Totally in China, we have five special economic zones. And because it's one of the special economic zones, so Xiamen has the right to manage its own economic affairs while offering preferred. What kind of the policies authorities that lead to the rapid growth in Xiamen? So the an annual growth rate of the more than 20% in most GDP and the total population. And the large domestic immigrated population happened during after Xiamen became a special economic zone. So the growth in economies and the populations is so rapidly. So this kind of the growth already lead to some problem in the environment. So actually, I think in China, in Xiamen, we have some larger animals in the sea area, like have a lancelet, and a Chinese white dolphin, and a horseshoe crab, and an egret. Okay, so because some environmental problem result from the rapid economic development and the population growth. So in Xiamen in 1994, we accept the ICM framework, the ICM approach for Xiamen to deal with such kind of the coastal environmental problem. So actually, up to now, we have a three phase of the Xiamen, of the ICM in Xiamen implementation. In 1994 to 1999, we established the framework for integrated coastal management and implementing strategic management and pollution control. That is the first phase. In this phase, we focus on the pollution control and the some management framework established. And in from 1999 to 2006, that called the second phase of the ICM implementation in Xiamen. And we improved the ICM framework strengthening the management of the land-based pollution and in preventing marine ecological rehabilitation. And from 2007 to now, we start and implement the third phase of the ICF. We improve the ICF framework, depend on the marine ecological rehabilitation. So that is three phases of the Xiamen. And following, I will introduce the Xiamen model in integrated coastal management, because that is the basis support for the ICF implementation. So in Xiamen, we could conclude the ICF model as these four aspects. One is legislation, another is the coordinating mechanism, and the scientific and technology support system, the integrated enforced mechanism, and the public participation. These five aspects, I think, is the component of the Xiamen ICF models. So, for establishing and improving legislative framework for integrated coastal management, Xiamen already has developed a series of plans in order to maintain the health of the marine ecosystem, like the Xiamen Marine Function Zoning Scheme, Marine Environmental Protection Planning, Xiamen Program on the treatment of tidal threat and the construction of the shelter forest, and Xiamen Wetland Conservation Plan, and so on. And these plans form it a rather complete coastal planning system to provide scientific base for implementation of the marine ecosystem conservation. And ICM legal framework and integrated enforceable mechanism has been established. So, under the national law, Xiamen already established some local law, like the resource management law, ecological and environmental protection regulations, and transportation management regulations, as listed in this table. And Xiamen is, Xiamen has a quite successful coordinating mechanism for ICF. So from this picture, you could understand that under the leadership of the mayor of the Xiamen municipality, Xiamen have a marine management coordination steering group of the Xiamen municipal government. And what with this group, they have a marine ecology group and have a marine management office. And marine ecology group, they have a function to work and to provide consultants and to implement some the idea or policy from the such kind of the coordination steering group. And for the marine management office, it is a body to carry out the policy and the planning from the group of the Xiamen municipal government for the coordination, marine management. Okay, and under the such kind of the management office, the series, or we said nine agencies, they work together and coordinate with the marine management office to support and to implement the Xiamen ICM. And for the scientific and the technology support system in Xiamen, Xiamen Municipal Government formed the Marine Expert Group to provide the advice for the government and its related agencies. An application of advanced technologies such as geographic information systems and remote sensing in sea area management. And routinely conduct the research on marine management and protection. And for an integrated enforcement mechanism, in Xiamen, there is a joint task force to oversee harbor supervisors, fisheries supervisors, water police, and environmental supervisors. They work together, and we establish the integrated enforcement mechanism and organize the joint enforcement actions. And not only within Xiamen area, but also we have a joint supervision mechanism among the Xiamen, Quanzhou, and Zhangzhou. Quanzhou, Zhangzhou is another two cities nearby, near Xiamen city. Okay, so because the sea area is together, we have the same boundary, so we need to have some kind of a joint supervision to combine with the two neighborhood cities to work together for such kind of the supervision mechanism. And for the public participation, we use of the media such as TV, newspaper, and radio to publicize the marine related laws and regulations in order to raise public awareness on marine environmental protection and enhance the willingness of the participation. And various interactive events on World Waterland Day and World Ocean Day in Xiamen also help the public learn about our oceans. I just some at least simple introduce some of our events, but actually we have a lot of events related to improve the awareness of the public. So, I should say that while a great success has been achieved in the phase one, I already mentioned that in the phase one we focus on the pollution control, especially control some land-based pollutants. And now I think Xiamen is going on a new circle of the ICM. We call it the ecological rehabilitations. Okay, in this circle, or in this kind of rehabilitations, as I list in this slide, we have some comprehensive treatment of the western seas, comprehensive environmental improvement of the sinking base, restoration of the Huyen Bay, east area treatment, and so on, that is related to the rehabilitation in Xiamen Sea areas. So, you could see this picture. That's the area for ecological restoration in Xiamen Sea area. Include some like the Lancet National Reserve and the Chinese White Dolphin National Reserve, and have a Egret Natural Reserve. And the green one is for bungalow replanting. And so many ecological restoration activities located in Xiamen Sea areas. So for the detail to understand Xiamen's environmental restoration, I will introduce some detailed examples for people to easy to understand. One is inland lake environmental restoration. Like showing here, actually Yandang Lake is one part of Xiamen Western Seas area. So before, in 1945, the map of the Yandang is like this. At that time, it is not called Yandang Lake, but called Yandang Harbor. It is a harbor, and it's open for the fisheries boats to come and to part in the boat there. So that is the harbor form. But in 1970s, because of the policy of the priority to prior agriculture to the other sea use, so the Yandang Lake was Yandang Harbor was changed to the Yandang Lake because the crossway was built at that time. So that is the map in 1978, you can understand from this picture. And this is the map of the Yandang Lake in 2001. You can understand that actually because the failure of the change the Yandang Harbor to the agriculture area. So finally, now the Yandang Harbor is was changed to the this we call it the Yandang Lake. So the lake, the sea waters area is much smaller than the Yandang Harbor. So in Yandang Harbor's size is about more than 10 square kilometers. But now the Yandang Lake just only 1.5 square kilometers large. And this Yandang Lake as the watershed, they still need to receive the wastewater or sewage from the surroundings, urban development and the industry development. So before the treatment, this is some situation before the treatment of the Yandang Lake. Like this, the pollution is very seriously at that time. And after the treatment, the Yandang Lake clean up successfully. Okay, so for this kind of successful result, I do three phases. In the phase one, very important is the enforcement of the sewage treatment prior to the discharge. Okay, so we construction of a sewage treatment plant with a daily capacity to provide primary and secondary treatment. That is the phase one. And the phase two, very important, is we establish of the second sewage treatment plant with daily capacity of more than 100,000 cubic meters sewage. And I think installing a pumping station is another important step. Be capable of the draining of the 40 cubic meters of the water per hour from Yandang Lagoon to the West Seas and improving the flood preventions. Okay, so that is another, I think the phase two have successful. And the phase three from year 2000 to now, that is another phase. And in this phase, I think very important is we change the mind from the hard engineering to the some soft aware approach to deal with some environmental problem or the environmental restoration. Something like the planted mangrove trees to improve the water quality and the growth of the seaweeds of the north part of the Yandang Lagoon, an experiment of the ecological floating bed with halophytes to help remediation study in 2008. So we try to use some ecological way to deal with the, some environmental problem. So that is the three-phase treatment, integrated treatment for the Yandang Lake. And such kind of the Yandang Lake cleanup obtained the environmental benefits, not. So before Yandang Lake integrated treatment, frequent red tides occurred in southern Western Sea area. I already mentioned that Yandang Lake is one part of the southern Western Sea area. And after the integrated treatment, despite the increase in total amount of wastewater discharged into the Western Sea, the seawater quality is well maintained. And the equity environment of Yandang Lake was very bad before the integrated treatment. But after the treatment, under the normal conditions, the water quality obviously become better. The water quality of Yandang Lake has reached the type B standards of the National Science and Recreation Water Quality Standard by now. So you can understand from this picture and the data that over the three phases of the rehabilitation, Xiamen sought a staggering increase in seaweeds. But however, the amount of the seaweeds intercepted and treated has risen in response. So like the copper sulfide and the suspected subject have also significantly decreased. So even after the first treatment, Yandang Lake saw a significant decrease in COD, VOD, and ammonia. Another example is the comprehensive treatment of the Western Seas. So this is the Western Seas, okay? And the Western Sea treatment is from 2002 to present. The program we face at that time is excessive aquaculture decrease the water flows due to the causeway and degradation of the wetlands. So that is the before treatment, the southern Western Sea, you can see the situation by that. And this is the after integrated treatment. So the area of treatment totally is about 70 square kilometers large, and the investment is about 230 million Chinese yuan. And the area of the removing agriculture is about more than 1,000 hectares. And the restructuring of the sea area use happened. So you can understand from here the steps of taken, like the agricultural removal, reclamation, restricting, opening of the causeway, draining out the sediment, construction of shore protection and wetlands, protection of the wetlands. So the result is quite obviously the Chinese white dolphin are now more common and improve the water quality, total nitrogen, total phosphate, and E. coli significantly reduced. And the water flow is expected to increase and increase the coastline and the sea areas. Another example is the restoration of the Wuyuan Bay. So this is the Wuyuan Bay before, and this is after. And such kind of the restoration project, we invested more than 1.5 billion RMB. And a natural wetland of the almost 90 hard was conserved. And former dike was opened. New islands were constructed, and a large rating and the coastline reviewed. So you could from picture could understand the such kind of project have a quite successful result for such kind of restoration of the Wuyuan Bay. And another example for the Eastern Seas Area treatment. So this treatment, we with drought of the agriculture so large and reverting the 4.5 kilometers of the land area to sea and constructing 5 kilometers of the beach and restored 1.5 square kilometers of the wetland park. Okay, so from picture you can understand before the Eastern Sea area is like this. All of the sea area were occupied by the agriculture. And right now, you can understand that the withdrawal of the agriculture and instead of the some bungalows replanted and the clean waters. Okay? So, we still have some restorations, like the Malam Bay. We bring in the reconstruction of the Malam coastline and construction of the retaining walls, construction of the wetland park, and broadening the water surface. And such kind of the environmental restoration, I think very one of the very important steps is bridging the causeway. So you could understand from this picture before in Xiangxi area we have a solar dot causeway, or we said or we call dike, like this. So we invest heavily in the project of the crossway breaking and start dredging. And I think such kind of activities to provide the basis for restoration of the ecosystem of Xiangxi areas. So like the picture show you, before is a dike or is a crossway, but now we use the bridge and to bridge the dike and the crossway and let the before the semi-closed space to become the opening deck or we say the opening sea areas. That would be let the water's dynamics capacity improve. So another activity is the rehabilitation of the uninhabited islands. So in 2005, Xiamen officially launched the uninhabited island restoration. Quite successful is in Houyi Island was set up as a pilot project. So you could understand from the picture that the, right now the island is quite branded. So on Houyi Island, they attempted to reproduce the beauty of the past through planting trees and flowers. Okay, and a green project, Tui Island, started in 2007. So this is Tui Island, and this is Houyi Island. And the public was also involved in Habitat Islands cleanup project. So we use such kind of activities to improve the public awareness for such kind of rehabilitation of inhabited islands. And the current plan in Jiamen is to restore one or two islands each year. Another activity is restoration of the sand beach and protection of the sand source. So from this picture, you can understand that we make some change. So on the basis of the sand beach monitoring and research, Xiamen launched the restoration of the Guanyin beach and then rebuilt a Guanyin beach which is 1.5 kilometers long and 250,000 square meters in area. So this picture shows you that nice before is like this. And after the restoration of the sand beach, now is a beautiful sand beach area for the public. So you could see the picture before and after the reconstruction of the sand beach. Another is recovery of the sand beach used the natural way. So from this picture you can understand this sand beach area before, because I have some illegal building, the building construct on the beach. So he almost destroyed the sand beach area here. But after remove the such kind of building, just only 2 or 3 years later, the beach recovered like this. Okay? So such kind of the sand beach harmony could be used to harmony between the land and the sea. So we have a lot of activities now quite frequently organized in the sand beach, and the people enjoy such kind of the sand beach activities. Another I think is quite important is the restoration and species. So from 2002, Xiamen launched the campaign, set the marine, the maintaining marine biodiversity through the habitats, marine ecological chains. So it resulted in the release of the farm rice organisms into the sea. Okay, so many species released were some fish and some the rare species, some fish, some shrimp, and some crab. So you can see every year we have such kind of activities to release the fish, crab, and horseshoe crabs. And we establish the protection and the recovery of the biological resource and rare species through marine function zone training. So you can understand from this picture, we constructed a natural conservation zone of the marine precious and the rare species. So this red one is special for Chinese white dolphin, and this green one is special for the lancelet, and this is special for the egret. And in Xiamen, Western Sea, a protection of the white dolphin, like the White Dolphins Protection Center, was built. And that is for the rescue the Chinese white dolphin. Someone finds that a Chinese white dolphin was killed, and then they would send them to the, this center for the curing. So Okay. And another is we have some regulation for protect the Chinese white dolphin. If we have some activities happened before happened, like the broding under the sea, under the seawater, and they need to use some measures to dry the Chinese white dolphin apart from the, that area. So that is some example that people try to do to dry the white dolphin apart before the people brought in for some construction. And the other is the inhibition of the invasive species. Okay, in Xiamen, I think the invasive species now we already found is the Spartana. That is one kind of the seagrass. But actually, we through this kind of the inhibition activities, now in Xiamen we have a we have established initial construction of a biological warning system. Okay. So another is the bungalow habitat conservation and restoration in Xiamen. So the picture show you, I think, could you to understand the such kind of the bungalows conservation and the restoration is quite successful. And we have actually now we have some established habitat rehabilitation plans for the bungalows and for the wetlands restoration. So I think the sustainability of the ecological system restoration, we could conclude that the ecological restoration through an ICL program can be sustainable if the programs benefit the economy, social and ecological environment, and the political willingness is strong. The management body is integrated with all levels of the stakeholders, and the scientific basis is sound, and the public awareness is high. Okay, so I could give a conclusion like this from my presentation today. ICM is through that the marine environmental protection and the ocean economic development can not only coordinate with each other but also bring out the best in each other. And in the future, I think Xiamen will continue to make the efforts in implementing environmental restoration projects and enhancing capacity building of the sustainable development. Okay, thank you for your attention. Any questions and comments, please.